Hi everyone, I'm Prateek, a dentist and specialty doctor. And in this video, we're going to be looking at the basic periodontal examination and why we do it. If you want to see more educational videos like this, then please make sure to subscribe to this channel. So, what is the basic periodontal examination, or the BPE? The BPE is a simple and effective way of carrying out periodontal screening on most of our patients. It is not a method of diagnosing, but it is a method of screening them so that we can provide them with the appropriate periodontal management that they may require. It's simple, it's quick, and it's highly effective. So which instrument do we use to carry out a BPE? We use the World Health Organization, or WHO probe, which has several markings in order to help us carry out a BPE. On the end, there is a 0.5mm diameter ball end. There are then two black bands on this probe, one running from 3.5mm to 5.5mm, and then the other running from 8.5mm to 11.5mm. In order to check the BPE for patients, we divide the mouth into sextants. We have upper right 7 to upper right 4, upper right 3 to upper left 3, upper left 4 to upper left 7, and then the lower arch we have lower left 7 to lower left 4, lower left 3 to lower right 3, and lower right 4 to lower right 7. In adults, we assess all teeth within each sextant, apart from third molar teeth, unless the first or second molars are missing. And in order for a sextant to qualify, there should be at least two teeth within that sextant. If there's only a single tooth, then this can be joined into the adjacent sextant, and you just put an X for the original sextant. In order to measure the BPE, the probe is walked around the teeth at all sites, and a force of around 20 to 25 grams should be used. This is essentially enough to make the skin blanch underneath your nail. As the probe is being walked, the worst BPE should be recorded for that sextant. In children, all six sextants are assessed. However, we use six index teeth in order to do this. We have the upper right 6, upper right 1, upper left 6, lower left 6, lower left 1, and lower right 6. In terms of recording the BPE, we have several scores that we can use, and these scores help us direct periodontal management for our patients. So in adults, we have a score 0, which essentially means there is no pocketing, there is no bleeding, and there are no plaque retentive features. So this is a relatively healthy dentition. We have a score of 1, and this usually indicates some bleeding upon probing, but still no pocketing or other plaque retentive features. So a score of 2 indicates that there isn't any pocketing, however there are plaque retentive features, such as overhanging restorations or calculus. Now in the scores of 0, 1 and 2, as there is no pocketing evident, the black band of the BPE probe would be fully visible, that first black band between 3.5 and 5.5mm. Then we move on to a BPE score of 3. Now in a BPE score of 3, we have pocketing between 3.5 to 5.5mm, i.e. the first black band of the BPE probe is going to be partially visible. There may or may not be bleeding along with this. And then a BPE score of 4 would indicate pocketing greater than 5.5mm. And this would mean on the BPE probe, you would not be able to see any of the black band. We can also use a star to indicate furcation involvement, and this can be done alongside the other BPE numbers. This is why, even though you may find a BPE of 4 quite early on in a sextant, it's still useful to check the other teeth to ensure there is no furcation involvement. In terms of recording the BPE for children, we usually start at the age of 7. And from the ages of 7 to 11, we only use a simplified BPE scoring system of 0, 1 and 2. And this is to account for any false pocketing that they may have. From 12 and above, we use the full range of BPE numbers. So like I said, the reason we carry out a BPE is to help us direct effective management in terms of periodontal health for our patient. So if we look at the scoring system, a score of 0, you typically just want to motivate the patient and encourage the oral hygiene regime they already have. With a score of 1, where we have some bleeding upon probing, you may want to just make some tweaks to the oral hygiene regime that the patient has at home to try and improve things a little bit more. With a BPE score of 2, along with oral hygiene advice, we should be looking to correct any plaque retentive features, so whether that's scaling away any calculus or adjusting restorations. Now under the new classification, with a BPE score of 3, if this is the first time a patient has recorded a BPE score of 3, we would carry out initial therapy, so correction of plaque retentive features, oral hygiene advice, and review them in 3 months. If the score still persists in 3 months, then we would treat them as though they have periodontal disease, and we would carry out a full periodontal assessment. With a BPE of 4, we would assume that they do have some degree of periodontal disease, and we would go straight to a full periodontal assessment. So there we've looked at what the BPE is, and why we use it, and the way it helps direct our treatment. My recommendation in this video is an Instagram account called The Toothy Diaries, and this is an Instagram account run by a dental student at the University of Sheffield called Megan. Megan's Instagram account is an excellent learning resource with plenty of quizzes and questions being put on her stories. Make sure to check her account out. I hope you found this video useful. Please make sure to like, comment and subscribe, and let me know of any other topics that you would like me to cover. Until the next video, take care.